Praise the Lord. I'm born again. Christ is Lord. My name is Pastor Hadassah Rosalind. I want us to share about prayer. And I know God is going to bless you. Even as you continue to share about prayer, I want to encourage you to be a prayerful person. And even as we pray, we get a relationship with God in prayer. I don't know who would want to have a girlfriend that they do not meet, they don't talk, they don't call each other, and they are still saying they're in a relationship. Our God, we walk with our God in prayer. We walk with our God in reading the scriptures. Those that are joining me, God bless you. Feel free to put your comment and God will bless you. I want to read about Jesus Christ. He taught on prayer, and I know we are going to be blessed. I want to start with Luke chapter 18 and from verse 9. The Bible says, to some who are confident of their own righteousness and look down on everybody else, Jesus told this parable. Two men went up to the temple to pray. One a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood up and prayed about himself. God, I thank you that I'm not like other men, robbers, evildoers, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week and give a tenth of all I get. But the tax collector stood at a distance. He would not even look up to heaven, but beat his breast and said, God, have mercy on me, a sinner. I tell you that this man, rather than the other, went home justified before God. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. Praise the Lord. The Bible is talking of a Pharisee and a tax collector. The Pharisee and the tax collector went to pray. And the Pharisee was telling God that he's not a sinner like any other person. He said he's not even like this tax collector. He told God the things that he does for him. And I would have want to put it across. Before you can tell God what you've done for him, thank him for what he has done for you. We are because of God. Even what we do, little or great, we do it because of God, through his enablement, through his power, in the name of Jesus Christ. That even as he says, I'm not a robber, evildoer, adulterer. He says, even like this tax collector, I fast twice a week and give him a tenth of all I get. So all these things that he was doing were good and right, but the attitude was wrong. What attitude do you go with before God? How do you approach the throne of God? Are you going to obtain mercy, or you're going to rubber stamp who you are, or you're going to boast who you are? Whatever we are, we have been enabled by God. And prayer is about humility. And the Bible says that he would not even look up, the tax collector would not even look up to heaven. He humbled himself and he hit his breast, asking God to forgive him because he's a sinner. This is an attitude I would want us to embrace. This is an attitude I would want us not to forget, to humble ourselves. And the Bible says, because God had the tax collector. The tax collector was a sinner, yes. He might not have been tithing like the Pharisee, but he had the right attitude. His heart humbled before God. And I want to challenge us as we pray. Are we broken in his presence? Are we of contrite heart? The Bible says, a contrite heart I will not reject. The Bible also says that God stays in heaven, and he also stays in a humble heart. Praise the Lord. God says he stays in a humble heart, a contrite spirit. And I want to encourage you that even as you pray, be of a contrite heart, so that God will dwell in you. A contrite and a broken heart is a humbled spirit. Even David prayed, create in me a clean heart, renew the right spirit within me. It is the spirit that the Pharisee embraced when he was before God that made his prayer rejected. And the Bible says, the tax collector hit his breast and said, I'm a sinner. And the Bible says, I tell you that this man, rather than the other, went home justified before God. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. God walk with the humble. And I remember the Bible saying that Moses was the meekest man on earth. And Moses is one man that saw the face of God. Moses is one man who spent 40 days with God, even before he died, because of meekness, humility. And the Bible says in Matthew, happy are the meek, for they shall inherit the land. They shall inherit the land. So God works with the humble. God hears the broken hearted. So as we go before God, let us break before him. Let us worship in him. When you worship God, you are belittling yourself. You're giving yourself out, and you fail to be that God can be. I remember John the Baptist. He said, let me decrease that you may increase. And God leads those that have decreased, those that are not just dumping, those that humble themselves before God. And we say, even it is said in the Bible, that there is no greater prophet than John the Baptist. You know, he was great because he decreased and God increased. So even as we go to prayer, I want to challenge you, embrace that contrite heart. Embrace even worship. Lift the Lord. When we lift the Lord, we humble ourselves. When we lift the Lord, we proclaim that he is God. And I also want to read Matthew 6. Jesus was teaching and he said, and when you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in the synagogue and on the street corners to be seen by men. So Jesus was saying, when we are praying, we should not be like the hypocrite. They stand on the, they love by standing in a synagogue and on the street corners to be seen by men. So that means our prayer is private to God. Our prayer is to God. Okay, that does not mean that we have to look for hiding places. I said it is in the attitude. When you are you praying for God to hear you, for God to answer you, or are you praying as a religious practice? Are you praying that we may know you are a prayerful person? You know, I want to encourage us to be prayerful. I want to encourage us to keep praying, but let us uphold the right attitude. He says they stand on the synagogue and say that they stand on the synagogue and street corners to be seen by men. So let the attitude of your heart be that your prayer is to God, that God will see you. And the Bible also continues to say, I tell you the truth, they have received their reward in full. That which, now, when they stand on the corner street and on the synagogue for people to see, now that is their reward. And I know you and me are not looking for that type of reward. We are looking for God to see us. And the Bible says, I tell you the truth, they have received their reward in full. But when you pray, go into your room, close the door, and pray to your Father who is unseen. Then your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you. So when we pray, everything, we close our doors, we pray to the Father who sees in secret. And the God who sees in secret will reward us. and you reward us publicly, we will see the results of your prayer. So I say it is in the attitude. Let us pray towards God, not towards men, not towards the prayer group we have, not towards the people we join hands with. Your heart be set out to God, to cry to God, to call unto Him, knowing it is only He that will give you the result. And that is why I say a prayer should be the exact words in your heart, because you're speaking them to God. At times you are not able to pray because you are choosing the right words. We are choosing what we are going to say, the impressive words. Pray as you feel it. Pray as it is in your heart, because the God who sees in secret will reward you. And the God who sees in secret, He knows the exact words in your heart. You know, for us, you can choose words for us, and we may not know that you chose them. But to our God who sees in secret, you cannot choose the words for Him. He knows what is in the inside. Bible says the Spirit that searches the heart, and He searches our heart. He searches the heart of God, and He can see everything that is in us. And that is why I'm encouraging you, because the prayer is to God. Pray as it is in your heart, so that God can be able, that you can be healed. Like when you go to hospital, a doctor will take, or the nurses, they'll go and remove the wound, you know, everything, so that they can dress it up to be healed. So when we are before God and we are choosing words, we are mindsing, you're composing ourselves, you know, we are keeping ourselves that to be acceptable, then we are limiting our hearts. We will not come out from that place healed. You know, open it, be bare, let Him see, let Him know what you are feeling from within, so that He can remove those wounds, open them up and heal you, because He's God. Let your prayer not be impressive, but let your prayer touch God, reach to God. And the Bible continues to say, and when you pray, do not keep on babbling like pagans, for they think they'll be heard because of their many words. And my key point was in this: when you pray, do not keep babbling like the pagans, because they think they'll be heard because of their many words. So God is not hearing us because of the many words. He's hearing us because of, you know, we have outpoured our hearts to Him. And for this part of babbling many words, I would want to encourage us to read the scripture, so that even as you pray, you quote the scripture. And those will not be babbles, because the Bible says He's exalted His word above His head. So God will listen to His word. He will be attentive when you're quoting the scripture, to avoid the babbling of the words. He says, and when you pray, do not keep on babbling like pagans, for they think they'll be heard because of their many words. There are times you use so many words. You know, unajaribu kui beef up, unajaribu kui weka weight. You know, the Bible is saying they think they'll be heard because of their many words. And so that our words do not disadvantage us, I want to encourage us to read the scriptures, to speak the scriptures even as we pray. That which you want, the scripture says something about it. If you don't know the scripture before you pray, you can Google, you can ask a friend, or, you know, the habitual reading of the word will help you to know which scripture talks about what I'm going through at this time. And the Bible continues to say, do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need even before you ask. So God wants us to ask, but as much as He wants us to ask, He knows what we need. And that is why He's saying, do not babble. You know, the babbling of many words. And I'm saying, when you are out, when you're pouring yourself, like I described before, at that point you'll not be babbling words. You'll be talk to God. Prayer is a talk to God. Tell him that you're feeling. Quote the scriptures if you can, and let him see you inside. You know, remove inside out, and you'll not be a hypocrite, and you'll be in the right spirit. And even as we have said in Isaiah, the Bible says God dwells in heaven, and also, you know, the heaven is his dwelling place. The earth is his footstool. But also in a contrite heart, when we open that heart to God, when we want, you know, when we open our wounds to him, we get that contrite heart. We are in the right attitude, and he will dwell within us. I want to tell you the power of prayer. You know, the people say prayer do not have power, or others do not experience answers from the prayer because they don't pray it right. They don't open it up to God. Like you're taking the heart, put it outside for God to heal it, for God to see it, for God to answer it. You know, take it to the Lord the way it is, the way you feel it. You know, dissect it before God. Open it up. And that way, you will not be mumbling words. You will not be repeating a lot of words. Even these prayers that we read, they are not from the heart. You know, it just becomes a norm, and they don't change much. So the prayer that we from the heart is the one that God hears. Praise the Lord. I trust you have heard the word, and you have been blessed, and that your heart will set out to pray, like we have read, that the Lord will hear you and will receive your prayer. And I want to pray for you, for the grace to humble, for the right attitude, the right spirit, that God will dwell in you. Even as he dwells in heaven, he will dwell in your heart. Even as you open it up to the Lord, that he will heal you. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for your word. I pray that we shall not pray like the synagogue people, my Father. Those that stand on the synagogue and the street corners to be seen by men. Even as we open up our hearts, even as we open up our wounds, Lord, even as we speak to you, dear Father, that you hear us, heal us, O God, and even dwell in our hearts. The Bible says that you dwell, you hear the heaven, you dwell in heaven, and the earth is the footstool. The Bible says also in a contrite and broken heart, and I pray for that contrite heart. I pray for that broken heart in my life and the life of my listener, that they will open up to you, that they will open their hearts to you, that you hear us, O God. And the Bible says you that sees in secret, you will reward us, Lord. And I pray even for my listener, as they continue to pray, that you open their hearts to you and you reward them, Lord. Those that are heavy laden, Lord, I pray, dear Father, that they will find rest in you. Those that are in tears, O God, wipe away their tears, Lord, in this season, Jehovah, that you've been sending a word of encouragement. I pray for my listener, dear Lord, be it that they are in difficult situation, that is why you're sending encouragement, Lord. Lift them up, O God, from the mighty clay, I pray. David said that he waited upon you, and you lifted him from the mighty clay. You set his foot upon a rock, and you gave him a new song. I pray for my listener. Lift them from the mighty clay. Put their foot on a rock, O God, and give them a new song. And David said, many sow, and they praised the Lord. Let it be for my listener. As many shall see, they shall praise you, because they will know you have done it, Lord. I thank you for this time that you've given us. We receive everything with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. So God bless you. For those who have joined us, leave a comment. Thank you very much for joining me. And I pray that you have been blessed. You can inbox me. You can call the number, and God will bless you.